Excellency, now the floor is open.
I am using this occasion, this opportunity, to address you and intimate you and the whole world of a letter I sent a few days ago to the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Walter Onoghen, alerting him of fresh plots by the All Progressive Congress to compromise a section of the judiciary and muzzle democracy in their desperation to oust me from office before the expiration of my tenure in October 2018. The essence is to silence me as the voice of opposition in the country because I have bluntly rejected all overtures to deflect into the ruling APC or stop talking. Where are all those talking and yabbing when PDP and the ex-president Goodluck Jonathan were in government? It is to be regretted that all have been silenced by the authoritarian Buhari administration. Fayose is the only one talking and standing on the side of the common man and the truth. And I want to say very expressly and clearly, I refused to be silenced. I will never be silenced. In my letter to the CJN, I allege that certain APC chieftains were again making moves to manipulate and compromise a section of the judiciary, particularly some judges, to get through the back door what they failed severally to achieve against me through the ballot box, as well as in open court, even in matters already decided by the Supreme Court. Permit me to quote from my letter to CJN. At a recent meeting held in Ado-Ekiti, the state capital, at which several stalwarts and chieftains of the All Progressive Congress were in attendance, two former governors of the state and members of the APC, namely Engineer Segun Oni and Dr. Kayode Fayemi, now a federal minister, boasted that there is no going back on the latest plans to subvert the will of the people of Ekiti, freely given. Wrestle the governance of Ekiti from me at all costs before the expiration of my tenure in October 2018 through orchestrated but dubious legal process, and thereby render nugatory the sacred mandate of the people given unto me openly and unequivocally when I won in all the 16 local governments of the state, while the incumbent, then Governor Kayode Fayemi, recorded zero. Gentlemen of the press, I figured out the hand of the presidency in their new and latest plot and their hatchet men, with Oni and Fayemi as their local arrowheads, most especially now that they are desperate Ekiti 2018 gubernatorial aspirants. A concocted fresh suit is being rehearsed and wished to be filed against me any moment from now, on the same old allegation in election that has come and gone, trashed by the tribunal and up to the Supreme Court in my favor. These plotters plan to procure the services of a compromised and a malleable judge to get self-serving Jankara and kangaroo judgment with the intention of having the Supreme Court reverse itself on the June 2014 Ekiti election. For me, I rather would expect them to go and prepare to face me again in 2018 and stop wasting their time. You want to agree with me that the Supreme Court cannot reverse itself? Yes, but you cannot put anything past these desperados. It may interest you to note that Engineer Segoni and Dr. Kayode Fayemi have boasted, as boastfully claimed, that they have enlisted the assurances of Justice Okon Abang and one or two other judges in the concocted fresh suit, inched on the report of a useless, meaningless, and senseless orchestrated military report not known to the electoral law of our country. As a responsible citizen and leader who has been at the receiving end of judicial rascality in the recent past, I urge the Chief Justice of Nigeria to take notice of judicial pronouncement by courts of concurrent jurisdiction, as well as the scathing remarks of the appellate courts on how the said Justice Okon Abang has been used in the past by anti-democratic forces to endanger democracy and engage in miscarriage of justice. It is my hope and prayer that the judiciary will not succumb to these dubious plots to undermine its independence and integrity and rubbish its good name and hard-earned reputation anymore. Permit me to say that the CJN has a duty to ensure that no judge under his watch is enlisted into this diabolical act by any rampaging anti-democratic elements. The embarrassing incidents currently play out on our national judicial horizon, with several judicial officers, including serving justices of the Supreme Court, enmeshed in stimulated and orchestrated corruption scandals and inducement by agencies of the federal government because they have refused at one time or the other to serve the base interest of the ruling APC government in matter pending before their lordships. Have kept me wondering whether the judiciary will succumb to this unwarranted harassment and intimidation meant to coerce it into submission and make this very important and indispensable third estate of the realm subservient to the arbitrary wishes, whims, and caprices of the executive and political desperados. You will equally recall that two justices of the Supreme Court made open confessions that they were approached to reverse my election at this final stage of the Supreme Court judgment on my matter last year. Whatever my detractors may say, By now, the whole world knows and recognizes me as a leading opposition figure in Nigeria, who has been very critical of the anti-people policies of the federal government and its anti-democratic actions that endanger our nascent democracy. It is right that democracy without viral opposition will eventually turn to dictatorship. You can all see with me now and clearly that we are under a dictator or dictatorship that we ought not to be. Frightful as the repeated shenanigans of the APC, Buhari's administration may seem, I will continue to believe in the judiciary, going by the open declaration of the CJN to defend the independence of a judiciary. I will further encourage the Honorable CJN to leave no stones unturned in his effort to maintain the judiciary's integrity and deliver a viral and disciplined workforce that is impartial, independent, not partisan, and not subservient to the selfish interests of any individual, group, or cabal, no matter how powerful. Gentlemen of the press, I am an incurable optimist who believes in the inherent goodness of man. In that wise, I express my confidence that the CJN in particular and the judiciary in general would not only refuse to fall for APC cheap and pedestrian blackmail, which I term banana peel, that is avoidable, but will also resolutely, confidently defend the hallowed grounds of the judiciary and secure them from desecration by anti-democratic forces running riot all over the country. I also have unflinching faith in the omnipotence of God, who rules in the affairs of man. This battle, again, is of the Lord. I have not been overcome and will never be overcome. Like others before this, it is not mine, but God's. He will fight it for me, like he has always done, and will give me victory over these Philistines. He who stands against me stands against God. I thank you all for coming. I appreciate you, and God bless you.